Modified Yokoyama procedure for myopic strabismus fixus. This video discusses the surgical technique of modified Yokoyama procedure. A 22-year-old lady presented with left eye anisometropic amblyopia with minus 14.5 axial myopia. On examination, these were her clinical findings. Her ocular movements showed restricted left eye abduction and elevation. MRI orbit showed nasal displacement of superior rectus and inferior displacement of lateral rectus in the left eye. A diagnosis of myopic strabismus fixus was made. The MRI findings showed an increase in the angle between the superior rectus and the lateral rectus, causing a herniation of the eyeball superotemporally out of the muscle cone. Left eye medial rectus recession with modified Yokoyama procedure was planned for this patient. This technique involves suturing the superior rectus and lateral rectus together in a loop 14 mm behind its insertion with non-absorbable suture. After medial rectus recession, a superotemporal fornix incision is made in the left eye. This allows better exposure of the posterior aspect of the muscle as compared to the limbal incision. The lateral rectus is then isolated and cleared from the overlying fascia. The posterior part is exposed with a malleable retractor. Millimeters is measured from the muscle insertion in two steps of 7 mm and a mark is placed. A double-arm spatulated 5-0 non-absorbable polyester suture is then used to take a full thickness bite through half the width of the lateral rectus muscle. Superior rectus is then isolated and cleared from the overlying fascia. Millimeters is marked. And the second arm of the suture is taken through the full thickness and half the width of the superior rectus muscle. Then both the ends of the superior rectus suture and the lateral rectus are pulled together to bring the bellies of the superior rectus and the lateral rectus together. The ends are then tied with a two throw forward, single throw backward and single throw forward knot. The ends are cut with sufficient length and the conjunctiva is closed with 8-0 Vicryl. Post-operatively, she had 10 prism diopter exotropia which settled to 8 prism diopter exotropia on final follow-up with excellent cosmesis. There was also improvement in primary gaze as well as improvement in the abduction of the left eye. This was another patient with similar findings who achieved good cosmesis postoperatively. Several studies have showed the success of this procedure. These are some of the surgical pearls that would ensure predictable and effective outcomes in this procedure. Thank you.